that you're going to filibuster anyone that President Obama nominates?
Absolutely. This should be a decision for the people, George. We've got an election, and you know, Democrats, I cannot wait to stand on that stage with Hillary Clinton or with Bernie Sanders and take the case to the people. What vision of the Supreme Court do you want? Let the election decide. If the Democrats want to replace this nominee, they need to win the election.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, joining us now is Carrie Severino. She's chief counsel and policy director of the Judicial Crisis Network and a former Supreme Court clerk to Justice Clarence Thomas. Carrie, welcome.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Well, it's my pleasure. All right, first of all, your thoughts on the passing of Justice Scalia.
Well, what a tragedy. I mean, we lost one of the best Supreme Court justices in history, and there couldn't have been a more crucial term, actually. I would have loved to see him carry out this term, because there's incredibly important decisions on everything from racial preferences, you know, public teacher unions, not to mention abortion, immigration action, and religious freedom. So now I think the big question is, are we going to let this president, who is consistently shown a lot of contempt for the Constitution, be the one who appoints his successor and to try to undo all of Justice Scalia's great legacy on the court?
Well, we've already gotten that answer from Mitch McConnell. It came quickly. I was on the air on WMAL radio on Saturday when this news came, and we were speculating almost immediately with Joe DiGenova as to what's going to happen. And he said there's no way that the Republicans will even vote on anything. And then right after that, McConnell came out and made a statement, which for him, to me, was very surprising. Would it be smarter, though, in the face of what has resulted since then and the criticism from the left and what we know the game plan will be from Obama and the media, to just actually vote on a nominee but vote it down if McConnell could, you know, make sure that that's the case?
Well, I don't think we know for sure whether there'll be a vote and everyone's going to vote him down or whether there's going to be no vote. But I do think it would be political malpractice for a GOP Senate to confirm an Obama nominee.
Oh, yeah.
They've got the majority of the senators. Again, this is the last president who should be filling Justice Scalia's shoes. And if there's one thing we've learned from this primary season, it's that Americans on both sides of the aisle are just fed up with Washington, with things being crammed down their throats. This is a great opportunity to make a point about the stakes of the presidential election and to say, hey, America, who do you want deciding who will be on the Supreme Court for the next several decades to shape the court for the generation? Let's let the American people decide and see what they say.
All right, there's some talk going on, according to SCOTUS blog, that Loretta Lynch is actually at the top of Barack Obama's list. Would that surprise you?
You know, nothing would surprise me from this president. He might appoint Eric Holder, who knows. I think what we do know is look at his nominees he's had so far. Justice Sotomayor, Justice Kagan. Trying to present both of those as moderate picks, particularly Justice Kagan. Oh, no, look, she's so nice to conservatives. And you know what? They get on the court and they vote in lockstep with Justice Ginsburg, absolutely on the liberal wing of the court. I don't think we're going to expect anything other than that from an Obama nominee. Whoever he puts up now, you know, is probably really just going to be a sacrificial lamb, because he knows they're not going to want to vote on someone. And so really, I think that's his effort to sort of drum up the base on his side for the election. But practically speaking, we know what an Obama nominee looks like. We don't need another Obama justice on the Supreme Court.
Carrie, let me ask you, though, about the recess appointment possibility. We know that his last attempt at a recess appointment to the NLRB was struck down by the Supreme Court 9-0, one of about 15 such 9-0 decisions that have gone against this Obama administration by the U.S. Supreme Court. But they were talking about he could do it right now, which apparently he won't, but that he could try to pull it off next January in the last 2 weeks of his term while the Senate is out of session. If that becomes a reasonable threat, would the Senate then, would you advise them to just stay in session, or how would you combat that possibility?
Sure. Well, the Senate actually is in session. It is out of session now. That's legitimate. The problem he ran into when he was struck down by the court is he wanted to do recess appointments before there was a recess.
Right.
When there's not a recess, you can't have a recess appointment.
Right.
And I think going forward, you're not going to see the Senate go into recess for those long breaks, because I don't think they want to give him that opportunity. Even if they did, though, even if the president decided to try to just pack the court with his people, that would really just, I think, even focus the issue more for those of us who are concerned about it. Imagine having someone voting on these cases, and you could see the kind of votes that a President Obama kind of nominee is going to be. I think that would actually even focus the opposition more. But practically speaking, I can't see him doing it. We're almost through with the oral arguments for this term anyway. There's not, even if he nominated someone tomorrow, you're
right,
not going to get them on the court for this term. And then by the time next term starts, you're practically into, in October, you're practically in the presidential election.
Right.
Anyway, so I think that's when we're going to really find out what happens.
Carrie, appreciate it very much. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
All right, folks, Gimme 5 is next. More on the whole recess business. Don't go away.